makes me nervous that my hair has to like look good because it's a hair tutorial. Hello, top of the morning to ya. That was weird, I'm sorry. So today I'm gonna do my everyday lived in hair routine. I'm emphasizing every day because I wash my hair every 4 days, I wanna say. So this isn't what I do every day, but when I do my hair, this is what I do. Do, 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 do. Okay. And sometimes, to be completely honest, I sleep with a towel on my pillow and let my hair air dry and then throw it up in a bun or whatever. My point is I don't dry and style my hair every single day. Instead, I do this once or twice a week and then use dry shampoo until I can't no more. You know what I mean? Now, you don't need all of these products to achieve the look. I will link more affordable options in the description box down below. So let's get going, bud. So during the week, I shower at night. One is because it saves me time in the morning, and two is I usually work out in the evening, and so I like to shower right after my workout. No, that's not a drowned rat. That is me fresh out of the shower. So when I get out of the shower with wet hair, shocker, I try to not twist my hair up in a towel anymore because I know that can cause breakage and your hair is really delicate when it is wet. So I don't wrap it up in a towel even though it's so gosh darn convenient. So I use this fancy towel to wring out the excess moisture. This is the Aquis Luxe hair turban, Lisse Luxe hair turban. What? I have the turban, but like I said, I don't like to wrap my hair up because I know that's bad. They have a normal towel version of this, but I already own this, so I'm not gonna buy the same thing. But the material is really nice for wicking away that excess moisture, and I find it cuts down on dry time, so that's always nice. Then I will use the wet brush. This is looking a little haggard right now, to detangle, and I like to be super gentle and start at the ends of my hair and work my way up to my scalp. Then, how do I explain this? I just kind of move my hair around to allow for better air dry. Like if it's too slicked down to my head, it will dry kind of funky. So I kind of just like zhuzh it. Wait, what? Dude, zhuzh is a real word. I was today years old when I realized that. Zhuzh, to make something more interesting or attractive by changing it slightly or adding something to it. Cool, moving on. Now I sit and let my hair air dry for ideally an hour. I really air dry for as long as possible, depending on how much time I have to get ready. My hair is naturally curly, so I use some of these products to assist me in drying my hair straight and also to protect from heat damage. First, I'll use the R&Co One Prep Spray. My cousin introduced me to this brand, I would say 2 years ago. And although I haven't tried a ton of their products, I've yet to be disappointed in a product I've used from them. And their packaging is so freaking cute. Then I will use a quarter size amount of the Briogeo Farewell Frizz Blow Dry Perfection and Heat Protectant Cream. I need a company to just be like, hair cream, and that's it. Sorry, I do love Briogeo, no shade, but like, what is up with the long ass names on these products? Anyways, I use this cream and I'll focus it at the ends of my hair and avoid my roots, because as the self-proclaimed queen of not washing my hair, I really try to push how long between washes I can go. And essential step of that is limiting the amount of products that are near my scalp, because that's obviously where you get oily. Because in my experience, there's a direct correlation between the more products make my hair look more greasier. Wow, that was a really grammatically correct sentence. Stay in school, kiddos. So the next step is to actually dry my hair. So I will just rough dry first with the Dyson Supersonic hair dryer. Quick shout out to my cousin, who is a precious gem of a human. She was generous enough to get this for me for my birthday last year. And holy chicken mole, has this been a time saver. We actually joke about all of the charitable initiatives we could put our extra time to, because this cuts down on blow dry time so freaking much. But really, it gives me more time to binge watch garbage TV shows. So when my hair gets to about 80% dry, I'll then switch to the Revlon One Step Hair Dryer and Volumizer. This step is super optional. Like I said, I have naturally curly hair, so this really helps me blow dry my hair straight and saves me from having to straighten my hair before I curl it. I used to use just this, but this thing gets hotter than the surface of the sun. So I only use it as kind of a finishing touch because, yeah, this was actually causing a lot of breakage and damage to my hair when I was just using it as a hair dryer. I know this is known to be a dupe for the Dyson styler, whatever that's called, and I really do like it, but yeah, it's definitely gets really, really hot. So to conclude the drying process, I'll then go back with the Dyson Cool Shot, the blue button. This is actually a feature on pretty much all hair dryers. In my mind, this closes the hair follicle after you've just bombarded your hair with heat. I don't know if it actually does anything drastic, but in my mind, it's a nice finishing touch.
Because Majesty, only powder. Gonna take this and this and give you
a princess.
I love the movie Princess Diaries, but the only thing that bugs me, did Mia never question how her single mother, a struggling artist, could afford a spacious, renovated firehouse in the middle of San Francisco? Like, girl, obviously your dad had some cash money to keep y'all afloat. Like, hello? Okay, this sounds a little silly, but I like to let my hair kind of rest in between drying and styling. I feel like after I've shocked it with heat, it deserves some time to just chill. Cause like, you know, my hair has feelings too, okay? That was really silly. Now, if this was a normal weekday, I would go to bed after I dry my hair and then continue the next steps the following morning. And then if this is a weekend, I would typically do my makeup whilst I let my hair sit and kind of rest for a second. I have a lot of hair, so to make it easier to style, I section it off to keep some of my hair out of the way and just make it a little bit more manageable. So first, I will use this little rat tail comb and find my part. I switch up my part frequently, but it's usually on the right side of my head. Then from my part, I'll divide my hair in two and tie one side with a scrunchie as to not put any dents in it, because a scrunchie is really gentle on your hair. Then I will first take the section that falls below my ear and clip the rest away onto the other side of my head. I will first spray the section that I've left out with the Way Memory Mist. I'll brush through that a little bit to disperse the product throughout my hair. Then I will curl one piece at a time with, I use the GHD straightener for this. So yeah, I will curl one piece at a time with the flat iron by clamping it a little bit down. I don't like my curls to start right at my head, and so I'll leave about an inch or two, clamp the hair, and then twist. And you want to use a consistent amount of pressure, but then I leave about an inch out of the bottom, and this gives it more of a beachy texture instead of like a ringlet curl. With each piece of hair that I grab, I will alternate directions, rotating inward and outward, or clockwise and counterclockwise, however you want to visualize that. And then I make sure the pieces near my face are facing outward or curled outward, because that's the way I like it. A key aspect of this process is that these curls do not have to be perfect. I actually find it looks better when the curls are inconsistent. So I do the same process of sectioning off the hair, spraying it with the Way spray, brushing through, and then curling. I'll repeat this around my whole entire noggin. And when I get to the very top layer, I curl all the pieces outward away from my face because that's the way, I like it. That's just like the way I like the curls to fall, is the top layer all being out. So when I'm finished curling, these curls are a little bit tight and I like more of a lived-in look. So with no rhyme or reason, I just kind of shake out the curls. I'll brush through them again with the wet brush, or our word of the day, I zhuzh my hair. Just kind of moving it around, shaking out the curls. Then I will spray my hair with with the Orbea dry texturizing spray to get some, you guessed it, texture. You can get the same effect with a little bit of dry shampoo, or I've heard that the Kristen S dry finish spray from Target is almost identical to this. I've yet to try it out, so I can't speak from experience, but that is just what I've heard through the grapevine. Or I have used Not Your Mother's Double Take finishing spray, I think it's called, and that's similar, but I found that gave more of a stickiness, so I didn't really enjoy that, but it is a texturizing spray that's decent from the drugstore. Personally, I'm not a big fan of hairspray. I will say partially that is due to the fact that my hair does take a curl, and so I don't feel the need to spray it with hairspray to maintain the curls throughout the day. But if you have pin straight hair or your hair will fall flat, now would be the time to hairspray it up. Go with your bad self. Alrighty, we're on the home stretch. So I don't always do this step, but I have quite a bit of flyaways. So I use the Way Matte Pomade and I take the tiniest, teeny tiniest little bit, rub it in my hands and press down on the flyaways and also use it towards the ends. Again, to just add some texture and some pieciness. You can use lotion or a hair gloss for this step, or even a bit of oil. What I love about this wax is that it is matte, hence the name. It gives you more of a grit than shine, which is what I'm into right now. I find other products that tame flyaways usually weigh my hair down, and I'm not about that life. All right, we are done. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you feel so inclined. I truly hope you're able to recreate this look easily. Even if you have a different hair type than me, this really isn't that challenging. If you're new to curling your hair with a straightener, there is definitely a bit of a learning curve, but once you get the hang of it, it'll save you so much time versus curling with a normal curling iron. So I recommend making the switch. All right, well, that's all I've got for now. So I'll see you later. Bye.